inching me out, and I remember screaming at him in just pure rage, and I was like, how dare you? I am a Sagittarius. I'm a die shark.
Okay. Next show, because I can't take the Zodiac.
Okay. Astrology women have got to go. She's acting like the killer would have been like, oh, you're Sagittarius? I'm only taking Leos. You can go.
Oh my God, you can't do that. I'm a Virgo. Julian, I'm a Virgo.
Remember yesterday how I told you the bombshell story about Tiffany Haddish being accused of child sexual abuse? She just released a statement. Is posting oneself crying in the bath to sad songs acceptable after a divorce? Kelsea Ballerini seems to think so. We will assess. Spencer Pratt says Friends star Lisa Kudrow is the meanest celebrity he's ever met, but can we trust him? And Kim Kardashian has a very interesting answer to being grilled about climate change in a new interview. I'm Alex Clark, and this is POPlitics. Yesterday, I went into detail on the Tiffany Haddish child sexual abuse allegations, so if you haven't watched Tuesday's episode, pause this, go watch that, and come back. In summary, last week, a new lawsuit accused comedians Tiffany Haddish and Ari Spears of grooming a 14-year-old girl and her 7-year-old brother before coercing them to film sexually explicit skits and videos that depicted them simulating disturbing sexual acts. Tiffany has just posted a statement to her Instagram saying, "I know people have a bunch of questions. I get it. I'm right there with you. Unfortunately, because there is an ongoing legal case, there's very little that I can say right now." She did admit the sketch was intended to be comedic, but that it wasn't funny at all. She said, "I deeply regret having agreed to act in it. I really look forward to being able to share a lot more about the situation as soon as I can." And then she turned off the comments on the post.
Doesn't look good.
Sounds to me like she's gonna go with the defense of, "I thought the material was funny. Turns out it wasn't. I had bad judgment." But man, if you read the whole Daily Beast article about what it was that she and Ari Spears had those two kids do, I don't know how you could ever misjudge what that content was.
Things aren't looking good here.
I said last Tuesday that I was really shocked and saddened about Kelsea Ballerini's divorce after 5 years of marriage to Morgan Evans. But now she's getting uncomfortably cringe, and I think someone needs to tell her to reel it in a little. Because she's been posting videos of herself crying in the bathtub to sad songs. Like, I know we've all cried in the shower, but is this taking things to the next level?
I'm sorry, it just hit me just now.
One note I want to make is that I love the song she chose to cry to. It's a massive hit on TikTok. It's called Complex by Katie Gregson McLeod. I actually included it on my September CUTEservative Jams playlist, which is on the link in her bio. But she's being really cringe by setting her phone up to video herself in the bath, crying to it after her divorce announcement. I mean, am I wrong though? You think like, no, this is really relatable. It's real. I like her more. Let me know.
I'm being a good wife. We won't be together, but maybe the next life. I need him like water. He lives on a landslide. I cry in his bathroom. He turns off the big light. I'm being a cool girl. I'm keeping it so tight. I carry him home. My friends have a good night. I need him like water. He thinks that I'm alright. I'm not feeling human. I think he's a good guy. But it's complex. It's a complex.
I hate when people post pictures or videos of themselves crying on social media in this type of scenario. Can someone say Bella Hadid? But all the comments under this TikTok she posted are overwhelmingly positive. CUTEservative Corp, what say you?
I did some poos, I didn't mean to.
Former reality TV villain, pop culture extraordinaire, and half of one of the longest standing marriages in Hollywood, Spencer Pratt, has called out Friends actress Lisa Kudrow as being one of the worst celebrities he's ever come in contact with.
Don't freak out until you're 100% sure.
But before you assume he's just pulling a JoJo Siwa by using TikTok to call out his rudest celebrity encounter, hear him out with the full story.
The year was 2009. Heidi and I were invited to our first real A-list elite party by the president of NBC. The party was held in the backyard of then chairman of NBC Universal's Malibu mansion. It was clear right when we got there that nobody wanted us there. It was almost like we were filming for Punked and the hidden camera was going to pop out. But Heidi and I didn't care. There was delicious food, open bar, beautiful views of the Malibu Ocean. As we were sitting there consuming a little caviar, Phoebe approaches, which was a little shocking since nobody had talked to us at all at the party. She then says, right in front of me, to Heidi, that she needs to get away from me as fast as possible because I'm going to murder Heidi and that I have the eyes of a serial killer. Heidi waits to see if this is a joke. Maybe this is a bit, a skit. Maybe this is a hidden camera show why we were invited to this elite party. No laughs. She just walks away. And that right there is the rudest moment I've ever encountered with a human being. No human beings ever come up to my wife and said that I was going to murder my wife and that I look like a serial killer. So, yeah, there you go.
After hearing all of that, are you team Phoebe or Spencer? I'm team Spencer because I actually think the reason he's been labeled a villain is that he always tells the truth and he doesn't care who it offends. For that reason, I like him and I believe him. I'd also love to get Spencer Pratt on the spillover. The invite is open.
Be our guest. Be our guest. Put our service to the test.
Kim Kardashian did a sexy, high fashion, and pretty patriotic photo shoot with Interview Magazine. I loved the photo shoot. She's got her blonde hair. They dyed her lashes and eyebrows blonde. Some of the pics are a little too revealing for me, but the ones with the American flag and her denim jacket are just absolutely everything. As you know, Taylor Swift, Kylie Jenner, and Kim have all been celebs called out recently for their use of private jets and not taking climate change seriously enough. Kim was asked about this in the interview, and I thought she gave a great answer to what was supposed to be a gotcha question. She said, "I believe in climate change, and I believe that anything can help. But I also believe in being realistic, and I think sometimes there's so much to worry about on this planet, and it can be really scary to live your life with anxiety." And while she enjoys learning from her super climate change involved friends, she said when it comes to her life, she needs to assess the practicality of going green at an extreme level by explaining, "I do what I can, but you have to pick and choose what really works for you in your life. No one's going to be 100% perfect."
Good answer, great body.
I was really impressed with her response to this. She's exactly right that when it comes to doing what's good for the environment, you do what you can, but you can't live your life in fear and crippling anxiety over something like climate change, which is filled with so much bogus science anyways, and typically weaponized as a fear tactic to usher in socialist politics. BRB, going to dye my eyebrows blonde.
Don't you dare. Don't you dare do that. Did you hear me?
There's a brand new CUTEservative Jams playlist for you in the link on our Instagram bio for Apple and Spotify. And then there's the new episode of The Spillover tomorrow night at midnight Eastern. Continue to heart and thumbs up each episode. We have been feeling the love over here lately and so appreciate you all. Today, we're discussing posting pics or videos of yourself crying on social media. Does it depend on the circumstances or is it always cringe? Is the hammer about to drop on Haddish? Do you love or hate Kim's new photo shoot pics? DM this episode to someone who lives in dies by their horoscope and always tap the save button. It's so easy and it helps us tremendously. We're back tomorrow at 4 p.m. Eastern, 1 p.m. Pacific. It's pop culture without the propaganda every single day. I'm Alex Clark and this is POPlitics.
Clearly POPlitics is best served visually, but you can also listen to POPlitics if you just want the audio. Subscribe to us anywhere you get your podcasts, Apple, Spotify, iHeart, TuneIn, and more. Also, make sure that if you are listening to the podcast version, you leave us a 5-star review. And don't forget, subscribe to POPlitics on YouTube.